in the material world we have false impressions of vastu, but actually it is not vastu. This table, it looks like vastu because it is existing for some time. Today I see, tomorrow I see, etc. But this is a illusory vastu because this vastu does not last. It's not an eternal table. It gives the impression of an eternal table. But in the spiritual world, there are eternal vastus, each having its own identity. A table has its own identity. Table has its own form. The table is the soul of the table. Satchidananda table. So you see the table as a vyakti, as an individual, as a vastu. You see everything in the spiritual world as a vastu. And in the material world also, we think this is this is that, this is that, this is a vastu, and you give an identity to it. This is a chair, this is a table, this is a floor. We give an identity to it. But actually these are not vastus. They don't last. They are all effects. That is why it is said this material world is a manifestation of three modes of material gunas. Guna means quality. Quality is not. Quality is the quality of, behind the quality there must be a vastu. That vastu is material energy of the Lord. The irreducible material energy of the Lord is one kind of energy of the Lord. Just like Brahman, you can say there are two types of Brahman. There is absolute truth is only Bhagavan, Paramatma and Brahman. And Brahman consists of what? Brahman consists of living in, Brahman means energy of the Lord. Bhagavan, Paramatma, they are all personality of God. And Brahman is energy of God. And we are also energy of God. The material energy is also an energy of God. It's another energy of God. So material energy as an identity, as one single identity, as a material energy of the Lord. And that has all these games, three gunas. It's functioning in service of the Supreme Lord. The three gunas, the material energy is serving the Supreme Lord in creating this material world for the living entity to practice their or to exercise their independent existence if they want to. And therefore there is a law of karma, guna, kala, karma. These are governing this material energy. All three, guna, kala and karma, are serving the Supreme Lord. So therefore, the supreme enjoyer in the material world is also this Lord, the Supreme Lord.